Welcome back to the Crooked Spine Show. Have you ever experienced upper back pain? What the heck's going on? Where did it come from? And how to get rid of it? In this workshop today, we had just done a few weeks ago at the Gibson Center, we talk about the causes of upper back pain beyond overall posture and how much we sit. Also to what the effects can be besides pain. Also to how do we rehab this bad boy, okay? What stretch do we need to do? Maybe lying down, a broomstick stretch, a corner stretch, we walk the dolls completely, along with strength exercise too. So once we build strength, that one can sit longer, stand longer, do more work and not feel fatigued and actually feel even decent after we have a long work day and recover faster from our day, say over the weekend, over the evening. So overall, we want to talk about too is having posture awareness, understanding what that means, how to check our own posture. So with better posture, we can sit and stand efficiently and not wear ourselves out. So enjoy the workshop, my friends. I'll talk about too in the show notes when they actually start the exercise. You can jump there if you want to. Also, go to the show notes too because the show notes has the actual video of this workshop. So you can actually see the exercise being performed. At that point, follow along, get yourself better. Look better, feel better, and be pain-free. All right, my friends, have a great week. Again, the show notes has highlights to our previous podcast as a video or a podcast and our previous show notes too. So enjoy the week, and I'll see you next week.
Again, I am Dr. Tony. I am a local chiropractor in Upland, doing this since 2016-ish. Obviously, a couple of years off of COVID. My job is to make sure you guys stay healthy. Guys, girls, at that point, we actually live a long, healthy, quality life. Correct? That's the plan. So our topic today is one of many, many, many topics I've done before. And what I do, if you're new to my workshop, is I incorporate a lot of exercises, part of stretching, strengthening, posture checking almost every time. But I want to make sure if you have a problem, for example, with back pain, focus on these. Palm and neck pain, focus on these. But I want to give you general ones too so your overall health gets better, right? How often should we exercise normally? It's like a Monday, Wednesday, Friday thing. What do you think? How often should we stretch? How often should we do things for our body?
I would say every day,
a couple times a day. Yes, at least
you brush your teeth.
At least every day, right? Yeah. I don't brush my teeth once a week like my one stepson did for a while. No. Gross. So can we do enough to make our body stay healthy based on the stress of our day? If we wake up every day, we're being pushed down by gravity. We're causing stress to our body, hopefully in a good way, over time, so we can live a healthy, long life and not let rigor mortis kick in. Is that the plan, right? Not too early, people. Okay? Today's topic is fixing your upper back. What I mean by that is, where is the upper back? It's basically the base of your neck, at your shoulders, down to about your diaphragm. Okay? We're also going to incorporate areas out to the shoulders, both sides, more like a pyramid, if you see my imaging pyramid, okay, to make our body understand it all works together, right? Part, our mid-back is connected to our neck, connected to our shoulder, connected to our lower back. We'll make sure everything's working properly. So, any questions yet? What causes upper back pain? So let me change the camera real quick to show you the normal causes is really this thing. What's this? Poor posture. Okay? Meaning that not only is when we're standing, do we sometimes lean forward on our toes, we do this, we look down, make sure we don't fall or we don't step on anything, correct? If we do this too long, our body learns this as our normal posture, our versus an ideal posture. Also, second thing, what do? Well, you might talk before, we do this. So like this, we got to get our bodies upright. We'll talk about more in detail down the line. How do we sit better? And I've done this all, I think every talk this year. How do we sit better so our body relearns this position or walk through steps for that down the line? Exactly, at that point you understand, okay, if I do this checklist every day, my body reset here, so I can stay here for a period of time, not have back pain, neck pain, shoulder pain, headaches, even leg pain or hip pain, and make our body have the strength to handle this position for maybe a couple hours and the endurance also. So walk away from my day feeling good, not like I gotta go lie down, it's only 3 o'clock in the afternoon. No, it's really, okay? So let's get our body strong. First of all, take away the pain. Second of all, get looser and then strength and build endurance. Does that make sense, everybody? Everyone agree? Yes, for the most part. Okay. Also, too, there are the causes of the back pain, such as trauma, accidents, car accidents for one, two. People that have problems where they get a car accident, a bad one, the seat belt will hold us around to the windshield, but it does cause sometimes mid-back or rib cage or even chest soreness, too. Okay? Traumas such as falls or sports injuries also, just everyone who's watching the videos not here, understands what causes back pain. Also, back pain also includes rib pain. Okay, when I have rib pain, it can be rib pain underneath the armpit, along with rib pain near the spine, along with rib pain near the sternum, near the chest area, midline of the chest. Having those areas looked at, want to make sure there's nothing bruising. It can cause problems where you have problems breathing, too. People that have rib pain or back pain get confused. I always ask them, is it back pain or is it pain where it's hard to breathe? It's hard to breathe. Most likely it's a caught rib where a rib can't move, meaning that if my ribs are moving normally, take a deep breath and they should expand. And they should actually, if you want to call it, contract as they breathe out. So that movement, if that's causing pinching when you breathe in, that's more of a rib. So I differentiate those, but also treat them the same, in the same type of realm of, if you want to call it chiropractic treatment, other treatments too. Okay? Next one, too, is change in physical stress. Anyone know the last, say, year or so has had a baby? Anybody? I know, like, probably 6 or 7 this year. Okay, people call them COVID babies. Stuck in the house all day. What do they do? I don't know. This is Facebook, so I don't want them to ban me again. Okay, on this live video. But what happens is when you have a baby, start doing this for like 6, 7, 8 hours a day. Okay? Breastfeeding, dad holding the baby. In the middle of the night, you're holding the baby going like, just please stop crying already. Go to sleep, please. My daughter didn't sleep for the first year, I think. She woke up, ate, cried, went back to sleep. I think, baby, that was her routine. So, changing physical stress too would also include if you drive further away from work. Do you have to sit more for work? Okay? Are you less active with work or more active? When we change our body and we change our stress level, meaning the physical stress, that change our body needs time to adapt. If we have an injury or a soreness or a trauma from before that has scar tissue, that can limit our ability to adapt to a new situation, a new job, a new trauma, or new stress. At that point, our body will feel that tightness not go away. So when I interview a patient, I want to go, has your lifestyle changed? Has things moved around? There's no trauma involved. What else can be caused, the onset or cause the problem? Okay? So another thing is the effects, upper back pain effects, how it can affect your body. We talked about local pain, being upper back pain here. Even sometimes if it hits a rib, causing rib pain that goes from the upper back around the shoulder blade, because your ribs really form that cage and like a shape formed from the back to your front, causing that thing to be more of a shield. The nerves itself travel from the back to the front can cause that to pinch all the way through that line. So some people come in and they're having chest pain. I go, I don't think you're having a heart attack, hopefully not, okay? We want to make sure that's not causing that, but if it is, that can come from the upper back area. Also, too, in here, and we talked about just chest tightness a second ago, even shoulder pain too. Realize the upper back is correlated with your shoulder blade. That shoulder blade area has a joint like the spine or like an elbow that makes it connect with your rib cage. That shoulder blade inside can actually rub, it can actually stick, causing that mid-back to be sore, usually in one spot, or even nerve pain from the neck that runs down the back. Look for all these things in our exam and also when you're talking about stuff too, to make sure wherever it's coming from, that helps us diagnose and give you the right treatment. Questions are just an affirmation.
Would you address something about scoliosis since that's on the list?
Exactly. Part of the good, you caught that. Someone has good vision here. Scoliosis as the cause of mid-back pain. So, if my back, instead of being straight, military posture, is more like this, okay? Not only does it bend to one side, but also the ribs will come back this way. The problem is when you have a lateral bend to your spine, the spine will actually turn or rotate also to alleviate pressure. So I may look like this, but I'm also going to do this. I'm going to bend to one side, my left side for one. At that point, I'm going to naturally turn to my right to alleviate that pressure somewhat. That rotation component will cause that pain in that blade, that shoulder blade area along the mid-back, and make you feel like there's a mid-back problem. So again, good observation. If I'm having this, I'm going to check someone for scoliosis by seeing, is there, when they're lying on their stomach, is their shoulder blade popping out, or is it staying in, to help really diagnose the scoliosis.
But
yes.
I would think that if you had that kind of posture, you would be more prone to respiratory illnesses.
Exactly.
That mm-hmm. just by standing mm-hmm. there, I can see that one lung would be kind of crushed.
So if someone has severe scoliosis over 35, 40 degrees,
yeah.
that whole rib cage pushes all those organs to the right side.
Yeah.
At that point, it compresses the lungs, the heart, the kidneys, even the liver too. I had someone come in many, many years ago as a new patient. She lied next to me on the side so I couldn't see her body yet. And she started talking like she had been smoking about probably 50 years. Heavy smoker. And she was only in her 20s. I had her face me. She looked like this.
Yeah. But her lung was like...
Her lung was this way, pushed
yeah.
over. So her lung was almost collapsed on one side.
Yeah.
Heart palpitations, heart issues, lung issues, everything.
Yeah. Because, do that again. See, I think that kind of posture would not only throw off your back and your organs, but also your hip, because you're putting more pressure on the whole lung.
The whole body.
Right?
The spine is going to be one chain, so when I walk, I'm going to maintain my balance. If my hip's already over here,
yeah.
my body's going to shift here to feel I'm balanced
yeah.
as much as I can. I can still walk versus having to fall over. The body, especially if you want to call it more common, 4 times more likely in female girls, because their body will develop faster. At that point, their body will shift to compensate. At that point, they get stuck here. So our job is, if you can catch it early enough between about 421, then the body can actually shift, because the bones are still soft, they haven't grown yet, they haven't matured yet, they haven't hardened. At that point, it allows the body to shift back to normal position over time. I had a staff member, sad story, she had surgery for scoliosis when she was 16 years old. So her body was stuck like this, had to grow this way. What happens is the lungs and heart are still growing, the organs are growing. So at that point, she had heart palpitations, she had a heart issue. They said minor surgery, she'll be back on Monday. Her brother called on Tuesday. She had passed away during surgery. At 20, I want to say 22, 23. So realize you have to take care of yourself. And if you're 21, we'll work on other stuff too. Catch it early enough. At that point, you can help fix it to a certain degree. Scoliosis is based on a degree issue. So if you talk about scoliosis specifically, the further I'm over, the more degrees it is. At that point, the further it is over, the more you want to get back to a better center, because over about 15, 25 degrees is where, now you know if you're 21, it can still get worse over time. So you want to minimize that degree when you're younger versus when you get older. Yes?
With scoliosis, what do you think is really the cause of that, barring any obvious trauma or something? Is it the muscle imbalance creating the bone problem, or the bones growing that way and then the muscles
developing
down?
So scoliosis, the origin of scoliosis is two things. Okay, hereditary is number one. Hereditary growth and also posture too. It can be, if you want to call it trauma related or surgery related too. So if someone, for example, I had a patient, she was a softball player in high school. Shoulder surgery. So her body had surgery, she had problems getting surgery, so her body's done this. But from here to here to compensate. So is it easier correction for someone who has a bone issue that grew that period of time? So most likely, if you had to guess on one, it's going to be hereditary. So our number one thing we do have to ask is, with scoliosis is does any of your parents have scoliosis? That's your number one thing. Okay. Has it been diagnosed also? And if they did, you take an x-ray to see where it is now. But number one thing is probably most likely hereditary, where it makes it more prone. The more we get the body to more of an upright position, the more it's upright, we take away that lateral curve to cause rotation to come back to normal neutral position. So early, catching it early is the key if you can catch scoliosis, especially a teenager, someone who isn't 21 yet. If afterwards, it's still fixable if it's under 20, 25 degrees. But it's one of those things to where, hey, where are you now? How do we fix it? Versus a wait and see, right? The problem is people wait and see, and it gets worse where they need surgery. Then you're having that long-term lifetime complications. Again, that's like a Debbie Downer thing. No. Yes?
I I have a daughter with Down syndrome, and they had said that, you know, in junior high, they checked for scoliosis is one of them, but she was one of us homeschooled. And so I didn't even think about the scoliosis thing because we were just busy.
Yeah, life.
But she does have a slight degree of it, but and my husband and I, we don't have it, but.
Sure.
So, but with Down syndrome, you know, there's weak everything in there.
Things are just thrown off overall.
Yeah.
Yep.
So, are you familiar with Down syndrome and scoliosis?
Yeah. We had a few patients like that before too.
Oh, okay.
So a lot of it is like any physiology. How do we look at the overall structure? What has changed physiologically with an X-ray? And from there, how do we change things over time? And if she's under 21?
She's 29.
29, okay. Wherever she is it possible to come back extension more, do enough exercising to make sure it minimizes over time so it doesn't become symptomatic? So that's the biggest thing. How do we minimize the curvature to make the symptoms reduce so she doesn't feel like she has scoliosis? That would be the plan B with that. Yeah, it's still looking at C, but it's nothing to where, okay, we can't do anything now. Yeah, there is. It just got to be more aggressive with the muscle stretching and be more proactive to make sure it's staying back in extension more versus being in flexion where it can bend and rotate more. Extension where the bones, the center of gravity minimizes, so it's hard to go in rotation and extension. We want to focus on that position.
I mean, I would third date anyways, and categorize
that
it's true.
Yeah. Yeah. The balance is also they have a wider gait, make them feel more balanced.
Mm-hmm.
So how do we, and that very end of my talk, I'll talk about standing posture, sitting posture. Standing posture, especially with walking, will help her minimize everything back here instead of being here where she feels she has to do this.
Mm-hmm.
But it's adjusting and feeling comfortable initially, so it's uncomfortable here until it becomes comfortable. It's time. But practice
right.
is key. As a parent, any parent, how do we monitor our kids to make sure they're getting that, if you want to call it, daily exam with our kids, so we see them change slowly when they look for it. We know to look what we're looking for first. That's it. All right? Good. Welcome. Okay. So also other effects of upper back pain, long-term can be neck pain, low back pain. So again, if I'm standing like this with a hunched upper back posture, my neck goes forward, so I'm not going to lean forward. I'm going to hold my neck back by hooking my shoulders up, causing shoulder pain. Neck pain can lead to where it can squeeze the neck and causing headaches and pinched nerves causing headaches. When I lean forward too, my back straightens out instead of being curved, making my back weaker. Making my hips tighter also, my body is shifting versus being anatomically where it should be more efficient and more of an upright standing position. Any questions about that? Good so far. This is the lecture part, so it is kind of like, sometimes. Okay? Other stuff. How do we diagnose upper back pain or upper back issues? We usually take an X-ray if need be. Okay? That'll kind of diagnose problems too. We also want to do this. Okay? We want to check posture. Get a little closer for this one. Sit a little bit further away for this one. Is here so I can see the wall. I want to do, and this is an important one too, is I want to go against the wall with my heels, hips, shoulders, and head. I want to see if that feels normal to me, meaning does it feel relaxed? Does it feel like any part of my body is sore, tight, or comfortable, or even resisting? I want to see, okay, am I here? Or do I feel like I have to lean forward more? When someone goes against the wall and they feel uncomfortable, they feel like they're leaning too far back. That makes sense? If my body is like this normally, I go back and I'm like, I'm leaning way too far back. My brain has made my body feel this as its normal upright, straight position. So when someone checks their posture, my new patient, I have them check, okay, so against the wall, and see how does that feel? So you want to make sure, what it feels like, where's there's tension? Where's there uncomfortable? Where has the bone shifted to here instead of being ideally relaxed here? Okay? Also, to sitting posture again, too. So sitting, we want to make sure we're sitting on the first third of the chair, okay? Here, feet, if you can, if your chair is wide enough, either underneath you or on the sides, so your knees are below your hips and your feet are on the side in line with your body instead of being in front. This is ideal. Because now our center of gravity is here, head, shoulders, hips, feet. Instead of being in front, but now it makes us naturally hunch. It feels weird. Ergonomically, people pay thousands of dollars, even $100,000, for someone to come to your company and tell them to put a stool out front so they can feel comfortable. I don't want to feel comfortable, I want to feel good. Okay? And I tell people too, the back of the chair, just for decoration. That's about it. Okay? Can we hold our body up so our center of gravity is here, our muscles work? They're not resting, they're actively working the whole time. Does this feel comfortable for some people? No, because it takes time to get there. Your shoulders might feel tight, your upper back might feel tight, your hips might feel tight. Good. Could we adjust the muscle structure again to adapt to a better position? That's the key. Any questions? Huh? Good so far? Look, go ahead. Yes, Sylvia.
Yeah, there's some chairs, I think they're called ergonomic or something, that
they kind of make you lean forward, right?
They make you lean forward and they don't have any back
risk. And people don't like it because it's uncomfortable.
It was very uncomfortable.
Yeah, because they don't realize it's test. You have to use that over time to get comfortable, but if your back isn't good enough, it's going to make it sore. Mm-hmm. So you almost got to fix your back and then it'll feel comfortable. That's a good test if your back's good or not for some people. Okay? I'll talk about a thing a second ago is also x-rays. So x-rays are key for us to see, is the spine scoliotic where it is bending for one, two? Do you have other issues that may be a spinal genital issues that we won't see without an x-ray? Especially if you have problems breathing, there's some things you can look for, like Schumann's disease, like that can be more of a, or even bamboo spines would be more of an issue for one, two, and kind of diagnose other things going on. Okay, any questions there? You want to see two with an x-ray, if you do take an x-ray, is the neck doing this, is the neck judging forward? Is the back too straight? Okay? So you want to see exactly structurally, does the structure that we saw in an x-ray match your posture? If it does, okay, this one we're going to have to fix it. Okay, helps us kind of see what's going on. Next thing, let's do this. Okay? How do we rehab? So number one thing we look for, someone with hunched posture, how does their shoulders look? So here, if I have hunched posture, my body's not going to stay here. That just feels weird to me. I'm going to do this. Okay, shoulders roll forward. When they roll forward, the neck will tighten up. The pec muscles in the front of the chest will actually tighten and shorten. The back muscles of your posterior delt upper trap will weaken to make you feel like this is your better position. Okay, this can cause neck pain, shoulder blade pain back here between the ribs and the shoulder blade for one, two, and even cause headaches if the neck is being tight versus being relaxed. How do we do that? Okay, I brought my mask for a reason. So here, I take two water bottles.
Any brand will work. Doesn't have to be this brand. Okay, so you guys know
nothing specific about these water bottles. Okay, what you want to do is get those shoulders to over time now unwind this way, instead of being wound up like a piece of rope this way. Any questions about that? My shoulders are wound up. Not only are the muscles now shifted forward, but the ligaments that hold the shoulder joint together now have wound up to make it tighter. Okay? People that have this problem too have problems they can't even lift their shoulders sometimes. What you want to do is go on your back. I'll be okay if it's on the bed too. Take two water bottles. If it feels good, bring them to your elbows to the level with your shoulders, lying on your back. Now bring those water bottles slowly at a right angle with your elbows behind you, where that's hopefully not too uncomfortable. Okay? Any questions about that? Questions? Can't see you. Okay, so what I want to do is when we do this exercise, we want to make sure we come down where if you can't go all the way back, go where it's uncomfortable. What I mean by that again from what we talked about earlier, when we're uncomfortable, the muscles are being stretched more than they're used to, and you can cause a change to your body. If I'm going where it's like, it feels a little bit uncomfortable, let's go back a little bit more. The more we can get ligaments, muscles to stretch, the more we cause a change in your body. Okay? So wherever you're comfortable, wherever you're uncomfortable, if it's even here,
Hold that for about 30 seconds. Relax for about 10 seconds. Again, 30. Relax again for 10, about 3 times. Okay, give yourself a chance to really unwind. Once you get to where it feels like it's flat, hold that there for about a full minute. Just once. Okay, so either 30 and 10, 3 times, or 1 full minute with the arms coming back. Okay. Any questions about that? And again, we're going to unwind the shoulders to start. Lying down is easy for some people because when you're in pain, what happens is you don't want to be in more pain. But lying down is less pain. I can move the muscle more versus when you're in pain, you're not going to really stretch as much. All right? Good number one.
You guys are going to wear me out today. That's the hope.
Okay. Broomstick stretch. Remember this one? Okay. Remember this one?
Yeah, no, you remember this one.
Change the camera angle again. This is what I use for a lot of upper back, even neck, things like that. Any connect with your shoulders, upper back, for 1, 2, the neck allows you to unwind it. So this is a good general stretch to use. And wherever you're comfortable. I have guys that work out a lot. They can't do this at all. They get so upset. It's phenomenal. It's funny. Actually, it entertains me. So I do is come back this way, elbow straight. This is the key. Standing up straight, looking forward, elbow straight. Come back, hold rear comfortable if you can, go all the way down. I know, I love that reaction. Okay, if you can't come all the way down, go where you're uncomfortable again. We make a little bit of the face, and then you hold that for about five seconds, and then come forward. Now, people do that about 5 times. I know.
Oh, why?
Okay, you're gonna feel this shoulder, upper back here. Even lower upper back in that area there. So my body's stuck like this. What's going to happen is it's not going to squeeze in. That's too much change of range of motion. You want to try this? Or are you guys good?
Oh, you did great.
Yeah. Like that? I practice every day for this one class once a year. This is what I practice for every day. This is my ideal workout in the morning, and this is my routine. I keep a Swiffer in my pantry, not because I'm going to sweep the ground at 5:30 in the morning, but because I'm going to stretch every morning. If I don't stretch, I tore my shoulder before, so if I don't stretch, it tightens up on. So any injuries you have, you want to slowly stretch, and over time strength. Questions?
Yeah, that's probably not a good idea to try if you are having a rotator
issue. Just got to go slow.
Yeah.
Got to go slow, and you want to start as wide as possible. Again, elbows straight. And go where it's uncomfortable, hold, come back then. I've had people that have shoulder surgery and done this, and it doesn't hurt shoulder because they understand where they have to go. You're not going to go like, I'm going to force, like,
right. Pop.
I'm like, that's not smart. Come on. Yeah. But you got to be careful. Again, you have to use your own judgment for one, too. Okay? So it takes time. Again, if you can't go all the way back and do that 5 times, you want to make sure you hold it for 5 seconds where you're uncomfortable. Hold, and then come back forward, do that 5 times. All right. Next one, I'm glad I saw the reaction I was hoping for. Stay there for the stick. Okay. Now, corner stretch. Corner stretch is, we're going to use a flat ball. No, use a quarter. Okay, I need to keep it simple. Very simple. So these are the first things. Corner stretch you want to do is, now what the goal is, how do you make that shoulder blade back here get closer together versus being too far separate? When we're hunched forward, the upper back muscles will weaken and lengthen out, make our rib cage lean too far forward. That thoracic cavity becomes too tight, too uncomfortable. Like scoliosis, if we're doing this too much, what happens is now you lose your breathing capacity. If my body's upright, I have better rest and breathing. If my body's hunched forward, I've lost some of the breathing issues. Breathing capacity or resting breathing range. Okay? So here I'm going to do now, quarter, I'm going to put my hands shoulder height, okay? This doesn't move too much on me. I'm going to take about 2 steps back from the wall. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to lean in and hold that stretch for about 5 seconds, then come back. The goal is to make sure those shoulder blades come together, they pinch together, hold, and then come back out. Okay? Any questions about that? 5 second hold, and then come back out. The goal, if we can get those muscles to contract, those rhomboids, allows you over time to now get them to activate the whole view here instead of being, here. I always do all the time. I always, when big bad posture, I always go, doesn't feel good to me. Questions? I like doing it 3 times. So 5 second hold, relax for 2 or 3. You can always add more if you want. You know, there's no like, there's no golden rule. You know, more than that, that's hurt you. No, it's gonna hurt you. You still have time though, okay? These are stretches. What do stretches do? They make the muscle lengthen, give you more range of motion, so the bones, as the bones move, the body can reset here. How do we maintain that once you feel comfortable where it's no longer hurting, no longer painful? Now, how do we lock it in here instead of locking it in here? Some people go, well, I work out a lot. Why is my back still sore? Because you're not stretching enough. You need the balance of stretching with strengthening, that balance. If not, we're just going to strengthen it here, maybe look like this instead of looking like this. You know, I think this 2020, this is better posture than here. Just me. Okay. So the first strength exercise is here, elbow side, walk, good, good. So here, we want to get, now that we've got the shoulder blades to stretch this way with a corner stretch, now let's move on to make those muscles, rhomboids, stronger to hold that, to really pinch it to make that stronger that way. So I'll go on the wall first to show you how you can do the exercise on the wall. Here, really it's an external rotation of the elbow. There's probably a name for it. I'm too lazy to look for the names. Here, elbows to your side. Lock them in, don't move the elbows. Water bottle is out again, and coming out with the water bottles, pinch the blades together, hold for a second, and come back. So I'll come off, so you can see my blades come together, hopefully. Didn't work them out today just for you ladies today, okay? Here, I'm gonna come in with my blades together as my hands come out, hold for a second, and then come in. Any questions about that? Make sense? So we want to contract them together, right? If you contract them, and then we're working the muscle. So for doing this, what's happening is now our chest cavity as a whole is opening up, giving us a better resting breathing. Okay? All right? Now we'll do this probably come out, hold about 5 times. 5 feels good, work up to 10. All right? If you want to do more weights, you can, but it's really not about the weight. It's about the motion, the movement, and really contracting, holding that contraction of the upper back long enough, and then relaxing. Okay? Next one. Here is a wall push-up. Okay? And what I do, I want you to realize, but being a wall push-up, it's not really for, say, chest strength or overall body strength. It's more to get the body to move better. So we get these muscles here. Again, if I'm forward, posture, bad posture. My body's hunching forward. Again, the pec muscles are tight, and then the shoulder muscles in the back along the trap are weak. Want to make them strong right there. So the goal is to make this stronger over time. So I have three modifications of a wall push-up. I'm going to start inside, elbows tucked in, okay? I'm going to come off the wall enough where there's a little bit of a lean into the wall, a little lean. I'm going to go away from this little nail because that'll be awkward and painful, and you guys will probably laugh at me. Here. Lean to the wall, elbows tucked in, elbows about shoulder width, really tight in there, okay? I'm going to work the lower part of the shoulder blade to start. I'm going to come in my body, almost touch the wall of my face. I'm going to push off so these muscles down here are working more. Any questions about that? Okay, so I'm going to come in, almost touch the wall, hold for a second. And come off. I do this about 5 times. So 5 reps. But making sure too, when we do the exercise, we want to stop for a second, then push off all the way. Okay? So our elbows are almost straight at the very end. Second one is here. What we do now is work the upper back, upper portion of the back. Here, I'm going to have my hand shoulder width apart and also shoulder height. But also now elbows about, say, 25 degrees out, away from my body. Again, a little bit of a lean still in my body to the wall, my head. I'm going to come in, pinch my blades together, hold for a second, and then come out. So I'm working this upper portion here now, not just the lower portion. Any questions on that? Yes?
Okay, so the first one is lower.
First one is lower here, and the second one's gonna be higher shoulder height here. So you're gonna feel different muscles working. They call them middle, high, low. I call them high and low. Keep it simple. You know, I like too many big words. It confuses me. What am I thinking? Okay? So last one, if that's uncomfortable, if that's uncomfortable, phenomenal. If that's painful, just be careful with it. Okay? Last, we're gonna separate them. I'm gonna take one hand behind my back. Okay, I'm gonna go about probably, say, if here's right about here, my hand, it's more of a normal push-up position. I'm gonna go here and lean in. Keep in mind, the goal with this one is if we're strong enough, we'll keep our body straight the whole time coming in and the whole time coming out. Okay? What I don't wanna see is this. Okay? If I have to be this, but not this, want to keep the body straight the whole time, body up. Again, wall posture again. Coming in, hold for a second, and then push off. Okay, again, once you've done about five of those on one side, switch sides. Here, at that point, coming in, hold for a second, and then coming out. Okay? Any questions on that? Let's get on here. Anything? Good? Anyone want to try this? Guys, get like that kind of word in me out. Just looking at it. No. But again, you can see the video later too. I'll show this real quick. You guys can see it. At that point, go to our workshop. I'm going to have this video up probably by this afternoon. By 5 o'clock or so. At that point, okay, what was that again? This is good here, but how's the recall? More compliance when you look at over and over again. Okay? If you're worried about the upper back being tighter and stronger. Last one. Reverse fly bent over. Okay? Take some more coordination. Same water bottles. So you don't need a lot of stuff. You don't need a lot of things to get your body stronger. These are small muscles. We really have to work, but they're possible. So when they get stronger, they hold here longer. It'll wear out by 10 o'clock in the morning. They're not done. You want to make them stronger, but it takes time, consistency of these exercises. How many times a week? Every day. Okay? Twice a day, 23 times a day can be like a extra person, superhero or something, I don't know.
Like when you brush your teeth, yeah. Exercise.
Exactly, brush teeth once a day, then rinse out with water, whatever, I don't know if it's an apple, whatever. So here, reverse fly. This is a bent over exercise. So I'm gonna do, I'll do it two ways. On a wall, I'm gonna do is bring my feet off the wall, about maybe a foot away from the wall. Hands will drop to the side, thumbs pointing forward. Okay, with the water bottles. I'm gonna hinge, not lean, but hinge at my hips, keep my back straight the whole time. I'm gonna come down, hold. At that point, I'm gonna do is make sure my head is up. My job is to pinch all of this up here together when I bring the water bottles up. I'm gonna bring them up this way. Again, thumbs pointing forward. Hinge at the hips here at the level of my ears. Hold for a second, bringing those arms down. All right. So again, we're gonna bring those. We're gonna bring that arms up here. Head going forward. We're gonna get that upper back, shoulder blade back here to pinch. We're gonna hold that position. Hold for a second. And come back down. So you want to make sure the elbows are also bent, just slightly bent. Again, the water bottles come up about ear level. Hold, then come back down. Okay. Any questions about that? If that feels good on the wall, and you have a good lower back, okay, here, you can't come off the wall, bend knees a little bit for your balance, and come up, hold, and then relax. Only thing that's moving is your shoulders and arms to pinch that blade back here together. Whew! Any questions? Anyone try this? So come on over. Yes.
Not that I know how to do it.
So we're going to try. A for effort, Sylvia.
That's right.
So here, up against the wall. Hips against the wall, right there.
Yes.
Okay. We're going to do now, bring the elbows here. Head up. And then back, hinge just like up. Up, 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 up. We're going to bring the elbows. We're going to go here. We're going to come up this way. Good. Here. Bend a little more. Bend. There we go. And come back down. Good. Come back again. Up.
Pinch, 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 pinch. Good. And then relax. One more time. Boom. Superstar. Right. Good job. Deck well too. It's kind of your life now, so be careful. We're on the floor. That's the goal. Can we do enough things to make our body healthy and strong? You're just three or four. There's a plethora. Okay. Enough moving things around. The next one is here again. Posture. We were just talking a second ago about standing. How do we check our standing posture? We come back against the wall. Heels, hips, shoulders, and head. Hold that position for about 30 seconds. Now we're going to come back to walk this way. We're going to take a step forward, weight on our heels. So we're back here, making everything here contract in our glutes, our lower back, our upper back. When you contract your muscles in our upper back and our lower back, you have what's called the erector spinae muscles. They contract all the way down the spine, and they go up and down. When you contract, then what's going to happen is they're going to pull you back more. Okay? So as we lean back, we're making those muscles overfire to hold our body up. We're going to stand on our heels, and we're going to walk heel to toe, keep our body up the whole time. Is my head going to the floor or going straight ahead? Straight ahead. So I'm not doing this. Again, you want to find where you're comfortable with the floor, where there's good space, there's nothing on the floor, especially if you have kids. At that point, most of them on the floor or a dog. At that point, or cats, maybe even cats, I don't have cats. At that point, we're here, head up, heel to toe, so our body's staying here, not hunching forward. Okay? Any questions about that?
You look younger when you stand.
Like that? I don't look 54 anymore. Good. Thank you very much for your compliment. Isn't it hard to know? Yes. Where's my cane? Where's my walker? No. Let's get back here. I come down Euclid every day. What do people do? They're walking like this.
Yeah.
You know, so when we think about it, because people just don't know, they're naive, right? I call it being naive. They don't know this is better for them until they have pain. Can we get someone to realize what normal is first before they have pain? Because once they have pain, go, now what do I do? So that help, my office, we said, most people come in because they have pain, now they want to understand what's going on. We get people to reset first, so before they have pain, they stay here, boom, they're up, instead of being down. Instead of being, good, good, good. Instead of being down, mentally, physically, now they're more upright, they're more positive. Huh. You can even like do a little step if you want, I don't know. Any questions?
Sorry, I have bad dry humor. Apologize.
Any questions yet? Last one. Okay.
Quick adjustment of the camera. Commercial break.
Sitting again. Talk about sitting again, just to repeat. When we sit, we want to make sure, like standing, our body's upright, working these muscles here so we get them to activate. If we activate these, they activate the hips. So we stay strong and relaxed here, edge of the chair, feet underneath us, the mind with our hips if possible, and our shoulders, knees below our hips. So everything is upright, contracted. Muscles contract, they stay strong, they stay relaxed, they build endurance, versus when they're weak, they tighten up. Loose strength. Keep our body strong and gain strength and endurance over time instead of being weak, tight, and down on yourself. Let's not do that. Alright? Any questions? I think that's it. Anything from the audience? Any Q&A time? I got 2 minutes. Any Q&A? Nothing? Think about it. Again, we see the video. I have questionnaires here. If you have any questions specifically about other issues from 1-2, I can always call you or send an email. My other exercise that I do have in my library of emails, your exercise that help other parts of the body too. Right? Again, I do this talk every month. I'm not sure what the next one is. They have it somewhere. But
September 21st.
What's the topic?
It is better posture. Learn the steps to check it, sitting, standing, and walking.
And also correcting it too. So we'll add, that's going to be, again, all of it's going to work together to make your body realize, I can do things every day for my body, whatever problems you have, you get healthier, stay healthier, happy, and don't get down on yourselves, people. All right? Thank you for coming. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Enjoy the heat. Live in the desert, we expect.